Hi, I'm Jessica Devine, and today I want to talk to you about Bartonella. Many patients infected with Lyme disease have two or three, if not more, co-infections. I got six co-infections myself from one tick bite. As Lyme patients, we are always having to listen very closely to our body to determine what co-infection might be flaring so we fight back with the right treatment. Some symptoms are very specific to one disease, but the neurotoxins from these infections cause inflammation in the brain and nervous system, so it's very complicated. In prior videos, I have discussed Lyme disease, officially known as Borrelia. I also have a video on Babesia. Let's move on to B number three, Bartonella. One of the most common co-infections of Lyme disease is known as Bartonella. Bartonella is a gram-negative bacteria that does not live long in your bloodstream. It infects cells that line blood vessels and is known as a small vessel disease. There are about 28 strains of Bartonella, 15 of which have been proven to infect humans. Bartonella is one of the most abundant infections in people. This is because it has many more vectors than Lyme disease has. Bartonella can be spread by ticks, fleas, lice, sandflies, chiggers, and mites. A common Bartonella strain actually causes cat scratch fever because it is transmitted by either the bite or the scratch of a cat. My research shows that 80% of all house cats and nearly 100% of cats living outdoors actually carry Bartonella. Most doctors have been taught that Bartonella is a self-limiting disease, meaning your body's healthy enough to just deal with it on its own without any treatment. And that is true for a percentage of those infected. However, for some people, this infection overtakes the immune system and runs wild and makes the patients extremely chronically ill. People with Bartonella experience pain in a variety of ways. There is pain in the joints and connective tissues around their joints. The joint pain even migrates to other parts of their body. As an example, you might have knee pain, and then right when you're about to see your doctor, the pain will literally move to your left elbow. This made me feel crazy, and doctors did not take me seriously when I tried to explain what was happening. Sadly, the most classic symptom of Bartonella is sensitivity and tenderness on the bottom of the feet, especially the soles. It made me feel like I was walking on burnt feet, and some people say it's like walking on glass or having a broken foot. Remember, BART is a small vessel vascular disease, so the foot pain can also be accompanied by neuropathy, like a pins and needles feeling that makes you feel like a pincushion. Bartonella also causes headaches with ice pick-like pain. The ice pick pain I can only describe as if someone electrocuted you. When they would hit my head, they were almost too overwhelming to bear. I would fall apart afterwards. Both Babesia and Bartonella can cause horrible headaches. But for me, Bartonella headaches were a tad worse. A Babesia headache produced weird sensations in my head and a deep pressure like migraine, whereas Bartonella prefers shock value, in my opinion. In addition, Bartonella frequently causes psychiatric issues. Depression, anxiety, OCD can be quite common. Many people with Bartonella infections are misdiagnosed as having refractive depression or even bipolar disorder due to their ever-changing moods. You can go from being very irritable to angry to being depressed in a short time frame. While it can be worth trying psych meds to help with these symptoms, sadly, they often make matters worse. Bottom line is, when psychiatric issues are being caused by a bacterial infection, psychiatric medications are often ineffective. Now again, because Bartonella is a small vessel disease, it loves to settle in the gut. Many patients present with issues like gastritis. I presented with that in the beginning. The second most common cause of gastritis, besides pylori, is known to be Bartonella. Now, people with active Bartonella infections often say they wake with sore throats, almost like you're getting a cold, and then it just goes away. I've had that happen countless times. Bartonella has been shown to affect the eyes, mostly through inflammation of the outermost layer of the eye. This makes a patient's eyes feel irritated, dry, and they often are red. Bartonella also is very known for causing frequent urination and chronic inflammatory conditions of the urinary system. Now, Bartonella can cause fevers, but since we have a broken immune system, many feel like they get hot, but when you go to take your temperature, it's actually below normal. This symptom drove me nuts. I'd feel like I was burning up, and then I would take my temperature and it would be like 97. Bartonella causes more skin-related problems than the other infections. Many patients have these red stretch marks on their skin, often reported up and down the spine. I was taught to watch their color as they lighten when treatment is working and bringing down the bacterial load. In addition, many with Bartonella develop acne, which improves with treatment. I had two doctors say, "They're just stretch marks," even when the location and the lifestyle did not show a valid reason for their assumption. Please watch my dismissive doctor's video for more information on their lack of education on these diseases. Now, Bartonella can live in the spleen and liver, contributing to inflammation. When those two organs are inflamed, you are unable to filter your blood efficiently. This causes thick blood and eventually like a congested liver. My nurse, who used to visit me weekly for blood draws, used to always mention how thick my blood was. I've had countless phlebotomists mention how hard it was to draw my blood. Now, blood tests often show elevated liver enzymes. The inflammation in the liver and spleen further compromises the detoxification system, which can cause swollen lymph glands, and that affects the body's ability to drain normally. Unfortunately, the testing for Bartonella is even less reliable than Lyme testing. Again, because Bartonella doesn't live in the bloodstream very long, there is frequently nothing to find to prove the infection is in the body. Galaxy Diagnostics is now the gold standard in testing for Bartonella. They have pioneered testing with enhanced PCR that is the most reliable testing available. I hope this gives you a little bit of insight into Bartonella. I'm hoping to end today's video with a reminder to check the description box below, where I've added the most common symptoms of Bartonella for reference, as this video would take hours to list all of the complicated systems that go into Bartonella. I want to add that two people in my family have finally overcome many of these symptoms. Please keep fighting and hold on to hope. Thanks for listening. Please share this video to educate your loved ones about this very serious co-infection. Please subscribe if you want to see future videos. I'll see you soon.